In this video, I kind of just wanted to touch a little bit on the shooting that took place in Jacksonville over a Madden tournament. First of all, guys, I just want to tell you that I have been a very big Madden fan for at least, I'd say, 6 or 7 years now. And honestly, after hearing this story and hearing what this idiot David Cates did, all because he was losing a Madden game, it's ridiculous. It's pathetic. It's just a video game, man. I mean, I know he's dead now, but he really had to take other people's lives and hurt other people just over a game? Like, seriously? I don't know if I can ever play Madden again after that, honestly. But, you know, stuff like this can happen at any time, so you always have to be mindful and aware of your surroundings. And honestly, if I can't even be safe at a friendly gaming tournament, I don't know if I can ever even go to one. And it's really sad that I have to say that, because I really do have a passion for video games, not just Madden, but all types of video games, whether it be sports games, RPGs, first-person shooters, a plethora of genres of video games. I've always had a passion for it. But another thing I wanted to say in this video is, yes, I'm aware that video games can be extremely violent. And I realize that there are people out there that believe that video games are what's increasing the crime rate and making people have violent impulses and stuff along that matter. But you can't let this one incident just destroy gaming as a whole. Yes, we have people out there that take things too far, but not the entire community is like that. But thanks to, well, for one, shallow-minded people, and for two, another, politics, perceiving gaming as something that's just negligent for just about anyone, like, it's just not cool. And honestly, I don't really care. I mean, I do care that people can get hurt over this kind of thing, but it's not going to ruin my passion. I'm always going to have a passion for video games, and I don't know, man. I really don't know if I can play Madden anymore, though. Maybe I'll get over it, but it may not look like it, but I'm actually sad inside. Really, really sad, and I'm sorry if I can't get my words out clearly in a way that you can fully understand, but it's really stupid, honestly. I mean, truth being told, that guy didn't deserve to live anymore. If he was really crazy enough to do something like that, it probably was his time to go. And I really don't like talking about death or, you know, stuff like this in general, but sometimes it's just your time, man. He probably just wasn't mentally stable enough to withstand, you know, failure, loss, or maybe he's just been dealing with this so much to the point where he doesn't know how to deal with it anymore. But anyways, there's nothing we can really do about it now. He's gone, and my condolences to the families that just lost one of their family members that they probably loved to death, and the fellow gamers that also had to pass because of this moron. Ugh. I really want to punch my computer right now, but I'm not going to. But anyways, if you don't remember anything I've said today, just remember that not every gamer is like that. Don't think think of a gamer as somebody that's violent, rude, mentally unstable just because this guy was. Please. That's all I'm asking for my audience right now, the people that watch this video. Please do not think in such a shallow and minuscule way. Please. Anyways, that's going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you guys for watching, and please share this video. Get this message out. This has been Conviction 454. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.